Ever wonder why camel milk has become popular? Why do some parents insist that camel milk helped their child with autism? Camel milk in the US is exotic. However, parents have been spending quite a bit of money to buy it. In other parts of the world, camel milk is common, and those parents are also buying it for their child with autism. Why? Hi, I'm Dr. Teresa Lyons. I teach parents the cutting-edge science of autism so that you can make the best decision for your child based on quality information. Is there actually a difference between cow's milk and camel milk? Why would one be preferred over the other? And here's the most important question: what does the science say? There was a publication that came out in 2022 that explored the effects of camel milk on children with autism as measured with blood tests. Let me get my slides so you can see what I'm talking about. And if you find this video to be helpful, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel to get the cutting edge scientific information about autism so that you can make the best decision for your child based on quality information.
Let's get into the science of camel milk. Nutrition strongly influences many chronic inflammatory diseases, with food metabolism being closely linked to inflammatory processes. Inflammation could be a result of a rejection of a food substance due to our body's immune response, and the interplay between nutrition, immunity, and inflammation has become a hot topic for research and an easy aspect for parents to focus on first in improving their child's health. This is the reason why diet and autism is such a huge topic, because diet really does influence so much of what goes on in our body. Cow milk. Milk is the primary dairy product in the beginning of many children's lives. Consumption of conventional cow milk is associated with small intestine inflammation. Conventional cow milk releases beta-casomorphin, which increases opioid activity in the GI system. Milk protein, specifically the beta-casein, is associated with increased intestinal permeability, otherwise known as leaky gut, and also potentially leading to neurological disorders, including autism. Let's get into the inflammatory effects of milk. As you can see here, this is a figure that's going to describe the milk protein inflammatory effects. This is taken from a publication about camel milk in 2022. You start out with the protein and you have casein and whey. So we'll focus on the casein, and you have a variety of different types of casein. So they're focusing on the beta casein, and there's potential release of BCM7. And so this particular protein, BCM7, is much lower in camel milk. It's much higher in cow milk. And yes, there is a typo in the publication. BCM7 is much higher in cow milk, and BCM7 contributes to increased intestinal permeability or leaky gut, which then can also influence an inflamed brain and impaired social interaction. That's the figure from this particular research article on camel milk and autism. The benefits of camel milk. So why is camel milk such a hot topic? Isn't milk just milk? No, it's not. So camel milk has become increasingly popular because it has a lower concentration of A1 beta casein. Additionally, camel milk has therapeutic qualities such as antibacterial, antiviral, anti-inflammatory, anti-diabetic, and anti-allergenic. Camel milk also has significantly lower omega-6 omega-3 ratio as an anti-inflammatory index. So that's 2.12 versus 13 of the cow milk. And it also contains 3 times more vitamin C than cow milk. Let's get into the study that was published in 2022 about camel milk and autism. So the whole purpose was to investigate the therapeutic potential of raw and boiled camel milk in reducing neuroinflammation. And there we're going to compare the effects of raw and boiled camel milk consumption versus cow milk consumption. The sample size was 64 children with autism. The age was 2 to 12 years old. The duration was 2 weeks. That is a relatively short duration. The pro-inflammatory biomarker used to measure autism severity was chosen to be TNF-alpha. And how these scientists measured behavioral changes was using the Childhood Autism Rating Scale and the Social Responsiveness Scale. They also measured gastrointestinal symptoms. Here's the methodology. So all groups received the same instructions, volume of milk, and containers to preserve the blinding of the study. And you can see how there were 64 children with autism, and they were broken into three groups. So 23 consumed the raw camel milk, 27 consumed the boiled camel milk, and 14 consumed the cow milk, which was, they're calling, a placebo. And these wonderful children were able to get blood draws, and that is what they were measuring, TNF-alpha. TNF-alpha results. Okay, what did the blood tests show? It showed that there is actually a reduction in inflammation consuming the camel milk, whether it was boiled or raw. Again, another typo here in the publication. That should be raw, R-A-W. But you can see here that there is an actual decrease in inflammation as measured by TNF-alpha results from blood tests. For the cow milk, you can see there's actually an increase in inflammation as measured by TNF-alpha. This was in the group of those with autism that was classified as mild to moderate. They also broke it out for severe autism. And again, boiled camel milk, you can see a reduction in neuroinflammation as measured by TNF-alpha. Here, the raw camel milk, not as much of a change, but again, a little bit, 6%. And then the cow milk again. So this is, and you could see how much of an increase in neuroinflammation there is here with the cow's milk consumption after 2 weeks. Here's some results about the gastrointestinal symptoms. So you can just see across the board, I won't go through all of it, GI symptoms did decrease with the camel milk. Conclusions. Camel milk has therapeutic potential due to its antiviral, antifungal, antibacterial, antioxidant, and anti-inflammatory effects. These effects are mainly due to two active ingredients, lactoferrin and immunoglobulins. Lactoferrin in camel milk specifically inhibits the growth of microorganisms known to be highly abundant in feces of patients with autism compared with those of healthy individuals. So it seems camel milk is addressing dysbiosis in the gut of those with autism. So lactoferrin is having an impact in the microbiota of someone with autism. Results demonstrate a significant decrease in TNF-alpha as a marker of inflammation in the serum of children with autism after consuming raw or boiled camel milk for 2 weeks. That was the study's conclusions. And that is why camel milk is starting to increase in popularity in parts of the world where it's considered exotic, because it has particular health benefits that people want. Camel milk consumption is accompanied by a much lower number of participants with GI symptoms. And I want to give a special thank you to Isha. Isha was a brilliant and fabulous nutrition science intern who worked with me from Cornell University. It was a pleasure to work with her. She is absolutely smart and just so determined. And I really appreciate all the work that she's done. And here are some references.